Oh, welcome to Team Visa TV Interview Series Season 4. I'm your host, IPW. I want to take this time to thank all my sponsors making this project possible. Big respects to Stadium Cafe, Amory Clothing, The Royal Family, Vision of Companies, Lala Closet, Hakim Graphic Designs, Inner Stand-Ups Entertainment, and Shimalicious Pizza, the best pizza on the south side. Special guest in the building, come all the way from Arima. Let's give it up for Mr. Arima. Now, she is the CEO of Blink by Nelly. Let's work on a TV, it's a TV interview series, season 4, Miss Tenille Holder.
I good.
How was the drive to come outside?
It was long. But we're here.
Thank
God.
Yeah, we're here. TV's TV. Yes. Yeah, give it up.
We
get lost though.
We got lost like 5 times.
What? True?
Yeah. Waze is not Waze.
Break it down for me. What do you mean you get lost like 5 times? Drive out lost on it? Go by the direction of lost on it.
The Waze carry me past the school going, so we made two stops.
Union.
Union, but they had a mark of the ways because sometimes they turn right, but sometimes they end up going straight.
Yeah, sometimes she just talk and sometimes she just say she give up and she take a break and she tell me when
she take a break.
We have to fight it up on the road and okay, that's it. Yeah.
Is it mood like right now?
Right now, I just chilling in the life pool.
Just chilling.
Yeah.
I want to say, what about TV, Visa TV interview series, season 4? This project is basically giving people the flowers. While that live,
right.
You've been monitoring your work and an excellent job you're doing.
Thank you so much.
Right, so let's break the ice. Mm-hmm. Can you tell TV that TV a little about yourself? Was Tenille Holder?
Okay. Well, I am 29. It's 29, right?
Yes.
I was forgetting that because when I reached 25, I was going backwards. But true. I say I'm looking good still now, so we go over 29, right?
Okay, big up that.
Right, so I'm 29. I am a mother of one. Understand? I'm doing nails in the beauty industry for 7 years. Yeah, guys, 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
I do nails. I do makeup. Yeah. I just do my little TikTok videos and things too.
I see.
Follow me on TikTok, Nelly.Holder. But like, I just give myself.
What followers you have on TikTok?
I'm not too sure, but I would really like to reach 10k, 20k, and I saw like a follow. I just try and think that it is. I enjoy it. And then we just flash over the screen and whoop. We're like Beyonce.
True?
Yeah. That's my specialty.
Well, then TikTok, we look like you wake up and then.
Yeah.
That's like.
Yeah, I'm going to.
Okay.
Yeah. So I can't do that right now because I'll start over.
In your words, can you tell TV that TV what is a technician, a nail technician?
Okay, so we have. People, let's mix it up.
Right.
We have nail artists,
mm-hmm.
and we have nail technicians, right? Nail technician work is where you're learning the foundation of building acrylic nails or extensions through gel,
right?
So it's more like, you know when you're building a foundation for a house? That's what nail technicians do. A mason.
Right.
So you're doing the groundwork and you're building up your extensions and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The nail artistry though, you don't have to be able to really do nail technician work to be a nail artist. You come on, you do press-ons, you could just started like drawing them kind of thing on people's nails. So once as an artist, whatever artwork you feel, you can put it on somebody's nail. It's different. Nail okay. artist, nail tech. Nail tech is the ground foundation, right? And I mean, all I can come and do my course, and all you little more.
More?
Yeah, more. We just build nail techs on this side and I run.
So you have courses and stuff like
that? I do.
Free courses?
I did one free course. And maybe I might like drop back into that in the future. I might give away a course or so. But for now, the course is $3,500. Wow. Yeah, and that's a beginner's course. You're learning everything I know.
So $3,500 for a beginner's course?
Yeah.
So if it is to go to the first level and it's expand from there?
Yeah, you can go on to the second one. Now, I don't give the second one, okay. but we have a lot of nice, like, places. We have places in South on this side of it, like schools, cosmetology school, that will give you the second one. I just give it the beginners.
Do you have an idea what the price range for you?
You could pay about 45 and up.
35 for the
second one? 45 for the second one. Right? So I will just do the groundwork with you. But yes, you get into learn nails, you get into start your business one
certificate
time.
Certificate and everything.
Certificate, everything ready for you.
The certificate license by under who?
Well, I did my course at Cosmetic Spa International. Right, so I got my license there. Now in Trinidad and Tobago, we don't have like a license board per se for nail technicians, not like America or England also, right? We have a cosmetology school that will give you the certificate and so on. And then from there you can build your business from the ground up.
Okay.
Right? So some places, if you go on to like the Caribbean and stuff, yes, you can get a license that could take you international.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like your spirit. No, I like it, my five. I like your spirit. Yes. I can run with you today. The name, Blink by Nelly.
Blink by Nelly.
By Nell or Nelly?
By Nelly.
By Nelly.
Okay. Yeah. But my name is Tenille, and I just shorten it down to Nelly.
Okay.
I don't know how, but we just get Nelly. I'll tell you, right? Bling. Well, I love diamonds. So when you come and meet me, prepare to get your nails bling on. Prepare to sit down on that seat for about 4 hours and get bling on every part of your nail. So that's how the nail come in. The name just come in, Bling my nail. Okay. I start blinging a lot of stuff too. Masks, I start bringing shoes.
I have my
Camera,
I see little glitz shining. What is it? Shine bright like a diamond.
Right, so I start bringing masks recently. I bring cups for carnival
okay.
and stuff. Yeah, we just bring jerseys, all those things.
That carnival too?
I love carnival.
The thing about the culture. Carnival.
I just love.
You think they should bring carnival next year?
No.
Come in?
No.
You don't think they should bring it?
It's been already.
Why?
I just think I think the cases are a little too high.
Right.
And carnival, we know everybody, if anybody know carnival, you're going to unwind, you're going to jam, you're going to sweat, you're going to get close. You're just going to be too close. I love carnival, I love the culture, I love everything, but we have to keep it safe.
What is place for carnival?
Well, last band I normally play with Tribe, I played with Island People. That was the first band of Island People, was deep.
So let me go Island People then.
Island People was the band. Then I move on to Fantasy. Then I move on to Tribe. Last year I played with a spinoff from Tribe. Can't remember the name today, but you know Tribe have like 5 different bands on the road and stuff. Yeah. So I out there, I extra. I bling him everything. When you see me, my Monday we're fully bling now. Yeah.
If TV's happening, what that band you go play?
Which
part are
you playing? Well, yeah, we can. We also, I can be the queen?
Mama Visa, yeah. I don't talk to Mama Visa. She will get the approval.
I'll get the boots. Okay. I just want to be the queen.
Right, now we get Tenille, right?
Yeah.
When did Miss Tenille realize that she wanted to become a nail tech? What's that about for you?
Okay, this is a nice story. I was in college, and I was in Costas, actually. Doing an exam, and this is your true story right
before you go pick up your school now.
My school, which school? Not Costa, right?
No, college.
Okay, no, not the college. We will pick up Eldo. I went to Eldo, bro. Okay. Right? I will tell you the story, I'll go your way. Right, so I'm doing the exam and everything, and I did prepare, I guess, but I didn't really prepare, I guess. I'm like doing the exam. I said, you know what? I'm a little too good for, with my hands to be saying, you know, in this exam right now, frustrating me. I was like, hold on, I'm 29 now, this is 7 years ago. I was like 21 or something. I was like, you know what, I'm so good with my hands. I love art, it relaxes me. I'm getting myself in a course.
Okay.
I started doing my course. Before I finished the course, I was on the road doing it. So I didn't even get my certificate. I was already in a salon, renting a station, doing nails already, practicing it. So it was just like a something just clicked in my mind. While I'm doing this exam, I said I'm going to do something different for me.
Right.
And it was a breeze and I love it.
I love it.
Yeah, I love it.
So the journey of going into this, right?
Yeah.
Was that struggle for you?
It was.
What's
it was tough in the beginning. Here's why. Mm-hmm. When you know status work, the like I say, nail artistry and nail technicians is two different things. I'm a nail artist more per se.
Okay.
I love doing art, I love drawing, I love this thing. So to get a technician part down, you have to do that foundation first to then do your art.
Right.
So that was a struggle for me, honestly. To just make sure the nail's staying on, to make sure it's not lifting. And at one point I was doing horrible.
Mm-hmm.
And I was renting in this salon. Mm-hmm. And I know big up the people in this salon because we are still good friends to this day. But it's so many clients and then they had like problems and stuff. And I tell them the truth, this is how it started off doing nails. You're not going to be perfect. And I am a perfectionist. So yeah, I started to take them criticism like blows to my
head. I heard already, somebody came in and said that.
Yeah, I started to take them things serious. Yeah. And I used to come home and cry almost every day. I was like, wow, this is so freaking tough. But I had my son and I was like, this is it. It's either this or nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Started to go out the road, giving out flyers like crazy. Online and every forum, if you see my all on Facebook, top different pages for different groups. If somebody puts up, I need a nail tech, I put up my page. I just searching through. At one point, I was just on my phone, right? You just looking for clients till I just get the practice and it just build. But it was tough. It was a tough experience at first,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, because sometimes in this industry, you don't really get the support that you need from other people. It's just a competition thing. I will be real. It's a little competition thing. But you know, I come in to take a little breath too, so I understand. But other than that, everything, the Lord just gave me all my lessons and stuff, and I remember. Yeah, stick to it, boy. Stick to it. I'm still sticking.
Your area is the Woodbrook area?
My area is Arima.
Oh, Arima.
Arima. I know you're not familiar because we come from real far. But I started off in Arima and stayed in Arima.
Mm.
I didn't move around. I wanted to, but I said I'm going to stick with Arima. And I have a lot of clients in Arima. I beg up all my clients. I love all of them. I appreciate each and every one of them.
So, being a nail technician was your first choice?
Yeah.
You had nothing in mind of being?
No, I didn't have anything else in mind.
Mm-hmm.
I liked doing my nails. Every week I used to do my nails all in a row.
Right.
I in school, I used to get all the nails. The teacher was like, you can't come with that. But it looking nice, right?
Mm.
And it was like, it looking real nice, what do I think? So I started doing the nails, like in the back of my mind. And I said, you know what? It's time to like actually put it out there.
Right.
And I did, and I never stopped.
So your courses came from when Costa then?
I did Costa, but I dropped out, I ain't gonna lie. Costa. I dropped out and I started a nice little cosmetic spa international. I saw the course, I went once. The first day I just started to pick up so quick. I started to teach so many girls in the class.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Would you recommend that to anybody who's viewing?
Recommend where?
The international.
Of course I will. I think they changed their name now. I'm not too sure, but I could probably get the information for you.
Mm.
Yeah, they were good. Okay. Yeah, and apart from that, experience.
Right.
You need to get out there. I would recommend that anybody who wants to do nails, even if you do a course,
mm-hmm.
people just be scared, but get out there.
And what do Bling by Nelly do to decipher yourself from others?
You see that bling, boy? That bling, boy. You hear that name? You see that bling? Now everybody is do the thing, and I'm not discrediting nobody. I have plenty of nails, friends.
Mm-hmm.
But you see them diamonds? Just how some ladies love it.
Mm-hmm.
And I give in here diamonds. Come, no diamond is too much. I do in your whole nail and diamonds if you want to. doing a whole tours and diamonds. I'll take my time, I'll do nothing. Once you happy, I am.
Yeah.
Going bigger than that. So, Blink, 7 years in the game now.
Mm-hmm.
You enjoying it?
Of course.
Blink, are you successful as a deal technician?
I would say so, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a beautiful clientele that follow me. I have some people who follow me from day one.
Okay.
You understand? And I mean, they're coming, they're selling the people.
Mm-hmm.
So, I would say, yeah. Yeah, definitely. I can stand on my feet with my business. I'm really happy about
it. And in terms of, reinvention, right? How often do you reinvent yourself? Like, go back to the drawing board, change up your style, come again?
Ah, boy, nails is something you're going to learn something new every week. Every day I'm online, every day I'm learning from YouTube College. Okay.
Somebody show me my Microsoft paper. Somebody show me my Microsoft paper.
Yeah, the College of YouTube needs to give out certificates. That does help. Because every week we have something new coming out. Every week is something I have to run and buy products just to get that look. Because whatever plane, I want to be in that.
Okay.
And I want my clients in that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, in a sense of like living with the latest trends, YouTube.
Yeah, definitely. YouTube, Pinterest, some Instagram now start to pop. We've seen a lot of stuff on the Instagram. So, yeah, you're learning new things every day. Never stop learning.
Well, I have some questions. Like, not fair, right? No, this is putting it to like. No, no, no. I want to switch it up a little because you're a young lady, right? I want to ask you, what's your take on domestic violence against women?
I despise domestic violence against women. Mm-hmm. No, everybody, I want to be honest here. It have a lot of women who can show bruises on the outside. It seem, you know, it seems she get cough up, it seems she get. But we also have the emotional part. And I despise that. I despise all.
Right.
Right? Now, the emotional part, I think, is the worst. Because you've not seen those bruises.
Okay.
But you're hearing that somebody's constantly bringing you down. And I'm very, well, sometimes it's free shame, but to be honest with you, I went through something like that.
Okay.
And that keep me down for a while. I could have been doing nails 10 years, 15 years, but... You know, when you're hearing people kind of just bringing you down, somebody like you look, you know, your partner is a difficult mother just bringing you down, right through. Yeah, it tends to, you know, give her toll. So I despise that. I, no. No to domestic violence.
No.
No to emotional violence. You want me ladies to stand up tall. I love my ladies. I love them.
Right.
Yeah, because when they come to sit down and I hear some stories.
Blink, that's what I want to stick a pin. You read my question, somebody stick a pin, yeah? But I know where to ask if you ever had a client who came to you and they're like...
Of course, I have many clients who come to me and when I hear these stories. Now listen to me when you're doing nails, you are also a therapist. And you know what? I am happy.
You love this, don't you?
No, I'm happy because I was doing psychology in Custard, right? And I was like, wait, numbers will fall in the same pattern. So while I file, and I'm like, yeah, kill.
Mm-hmm.
And what happened next? And so I'm like, you need to stand up on your own too. Yeah, what to do? You might not have any cash now, but you know, you need to come, let me teach you something and start a business on your own. Stand up on your 2 feet. You know, I love to let women be independent. You know, so yes, we have a lot of ladies out here who really hurting. My heart is good for them, but it always have a way to turn around.
Mm-hmm.
It always have a way. And I think each woman should teach me anything you want to do. If it's hair, if it's nails, if it's sewing.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? If you're going outside and you're thinking mixing concrete, make it your own. I just advise from my students, you know, get a business registered and do the thing correct.
Okay.
Then every woman stand up to.
Let me get that first.
Yeah.
You use the arm. You're good energy.
I know.
Though, you are telling that because that's certain things mark out here for you, right?
And I hit it.
Yeah, you hit it.
Yeah.
Before I even ask it. No, you're using it. No, like seriously. You're using to, you know, still your female friends, clients.
Yeah.
No, be like independent, right?
Yeah, I know.
And I actually have a question, and I don't just feel like this independent thing. What's your take on women who independence carry them to a place of loneliness?
You think so?
In a sense of, we'll break it off here.
I think
there's some men who feel or know that independent.
Yeah.
I'm home for no man. I God, I should forward.
I
when
you
go home that bad, she's in the job.
No, he right. He right. I'll tell you the whole truth and tell you the truth because I'm not truthful. Uh-huh. That is the truth, and I know how to fall in that bracket too.
Okay.
You understand? But I take everything with moderation. I think that, yes, we're independent, but you still need a companion and you still need to respect each other. I think if we respect each other, that will come off that way.
Right.
It's okay to have your money saved. It's okay to be on top of your bills. It's okay to take care of all your kids. And you know everything going good with you, you have your business and stuff, but don't mutually disrespect.
Don't independence your way into
yeah, me. Because then
yes.
You all and
well, yeah, that.
Yeah. We don't know. We can take you in good.
For any bad cheese and the puppy belly though.
Yeah. And all we women, we feel like we can run things now in Trino.
In terms of your art, right?
Uh-huh.
Can you tell to Visa TV what is your strength and like your weakness? Like separate.
Strength. Okay, but I will always bring it back to the bling because anything could go in a nail for me. I put in anything on that nail, that's my strength. But I put in anything on the nail. Yes, I put marijuana, I put money, it has some big sweetie, you can make anything and put it on the nail. You understand?
Yeah.
It could stay on and will stay on.
Yeah.
But sometimes it will stay on too good that your nail might go too. So I'll say that's my strength, right?
Yeah.
The weakness, oh gosh, the most difficult thing I've ever done in nails was gel nails. For nothing, 7 years, I could get gel nails. I don't even offer it, I'm being because I can't get a try all. Oh, that's
which
my weakness. It's something different from acrylic. Now, acrylic is more synthetic and gel is more organic.
Mm-hmm.
Organic, the organic matter in the gel will grow your nails.
Mm-hmm.
But the acrylic, it tends to damage and weaken the nails. So people who are there trying to grow the nails with acrylic, it's not going to work. Just saying that.
Of course, I don't want to ask nail techs like yourself.
Uh-huh.
You always use like crazy glue to put on nails.
We do not. But for some reason, I feel that nail glue. No, the nail glue just feel like crazy glue to me. Because it had moments where I was sticking on tips on somebody and the tips stick to my finger and couldn't come off.
Okay.
Yeah, I had to actually soak it off and acetone dye. It's a little stronger than it. So I don't, I say it's crazy glue, but for some reason it feels like crazy glue. It's not.
And being in general, who experienced injury? Yeah, client.
No. Thank God. I take my time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I follow all the rules. Once you follow all the rules, your clients will be fine.
What is yours?
Well, first of all, anybody using an e-file needs to do an e-file class. That is one thing that could really damage somebody's nails. The cutting and the cuticles, those things you have to take your time with. Once you're following that guideline, which is the prep work of the nails, you should be fine. Mm-hmm. And also, diabetic people should not be doing pedicures, diabetes. People with diabetes should not be getting cut. And sometimes while you're doing a pedicure, you could cut somebody,
mm-hmm.
right? It might be a big cut, but somebody who's diabetic could get an infection, right?
Right?
Once you follow the rules, you come back and you refill on time. You know, you're not bouncing. If somebody bounces a nail, mm-hmm. you just refill on top of it. You check the person's nails. So you have to care for these people's nails as well.
Mm-hmm.
Once you do the thing proper, some people just want to come. Running and getting to it, I say no, we have to check your nails, make sure your nails are good. Grab on this acrylic for a month, 2 months, let's take it off. You know, moderation.
Mm-hmm.
So once you're following that, nobody's not going to get any big, yeah, no injuries in the workplace. We just have nice guys in the workplace. Yeah.
Joseph.
Yeah, sure.
Joseph?
Joe is there.
She's a big ass.
Yeah.
Big girl. No, she begs you, man. What's your best style suit? Look at my tennis.
You come to ask me, see the bling? You need to understand, I don't want to say it's the most technical thing, but I love, right now I'm doing press-ons, right? And the latest that I did was the Sneaky Link press-on. That was the biggest, and I was really proud of myself. I took 3 days to do that press-on set, because I got to do plenty drawing, I got to do plenty bling, and I was really happy with the outcome of that. So, yeah, that's my style and the art world, the kind of graffiti, kind of put some girl on the block with all the big gems and all that kind of thing, the long, long Cardi B kind of finish, that's me. That's my nails. Yeah, like those long bling. When you see me, you see my nails before you see me.
Who do your nails for you?
I do my nails.
For yourself?
Yeah. I have one friend, Abixia B. Nails. She's an amazing artist. I will go and sit down with her and do my nails if I'm not feeling to do it. But most of the time, I don't have time, so I do my own nails late in the night.
Yeah. Let's talk about the prices now for this.
Nail sets? Mm-hmm. Acrylic could start at 200 by me. It's 200 and up. So it depends on your length, your style, the amount of bling. It could go up to about $500, depending on the bling, the length, the style.
You've had a client, maybe usually 1,000?
I never had. Maybe you have to do like a bunch of stuff. So if you do the hands and the nails and then the bling or that whole thing, yeah, it might be all the way up there. Mm-hmm. Especially extra long lengths. That some people really like some lengths. We have this thick tip, one top tip, one top tip, and then file that together. So it's been a lot of work. It's still on hold it with me. Once you're comfortable, I'm comfortable.
What's the biggest trick you ever seen to me?
Boy, it was at Christmas, boy. Christmas was nice.
I hear the story, man.
The Christmas was nice. I want to come, you figure too much, but when I check back my book and I see that,
No, what inspires Lynn Minnelli? What motivates you?
My son. My beautiful son. I can have a bad day, and as soon as I see him, I'm like, Mommy, gotta get up and do this work and get it together so we can do stuff.
So, Lynn Minnelli. Motivation and inspiration.
It's my son. His name is Raphael. He's 5 years old.
Short to look.
Yes. Yes, he loves it.
Can you name some of your goals that you want to accomplish?
Okay, well, I would definitely want a full spa. A full spa with people working. I don't want to say it, like, for me, giving people opportunity, I would like to do that. That's one big goal. The second big goal I would like to have is my own home, my nice dream home.
Working
hard at that. A nice, not a big house. I really like to clean too much of a big house, but a nice home that's mine.
I remember myself.
When I was growing up, we moved around a lot because we were renting. So I really want to just put on a foundation. That is one big dream for me. The next one, I have a checklist there. Now, this is really good as business people. You write a list down and start to check it off, even if it's a small list. Right, so I have a checklist and we're going with a list. We'll travel the world one day. That's one of my dreams. You know, get married one day. That's my next goal. You know, anything could be a goal, right? So yeah.
Smear it on. Put your ring on the finger.
I want a big wedding. I want a whole boat cruise. I rail extra. You know, like I want a boat ride for my wedding. I don't want no 20 people. What is that?
No, a boat ride.
I want a whole boat ride, boy.
Then big cruise ship.
Big thing, long day, boy.
You can feed all these people.
I'm feeling them people. I want that.
I rail meals so to feed all these people.
We go even if we eat a little, you know, little finger food, we eat in that. And you know, you go pray because we're whining and we're drinking and we're having a good time. So we celebrate this moment because when I get married, there's only one time I want to get married.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Big up,
Pete. Yeah, and I don't believe in that divorce thing. We had to fight it out. Yeah, even God forbid we could have an Angela, but we had to fight out.
Well, tell him now, so you can hear.
Of course, he writes here. You can hear.
Big up, Pete.
I was gonna want to ask you. If you could go back 5 years from this day,
yeah.
What would you tell little Lil back then? I suppose only little Lil.
Well, I tell
to
not procrastinate.
Do not
procrastinate.
Why?
Don't, because I felt like I could have reached further.
Okay.
But I had a little voice in my head saying I can't really do much, and I believe that, but no, I want to believe in me, believe in my God, and believe in me, and you will make it. So I would tell that girl, believe in yourself, no matter what nobody tell you, and it will be truly fun. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Big. What message would you send a young aspiring girl?
Don't give up. do not give up. It may be rough, and there are some people who may not like your styling, but you will find people who would like your styling. So just don't give up. Keep going. And yeah, you will reach really far once you keep going. Consistency is key. That's it.
That shoe cam segment here. Oh, I don't know what you presented this today.
But really? Yes, we're ready for
the shoe cam segment?
Yeah, of course. We mean how we presented this. We put it on for this.
Yeah, that presented to the camera and get you details about the shoes. But no.
Oh, it's ready, you know.
But I'm saying that. I find it quite up here.
Well,
so
you can see it.
It's
okay, most of me is the shoe today.
Yeah.
That's right, we're working with the shoe.
Yeah, big up, Nick. Big up, Nick. Blame my Nelly.
Oh, yeah.
On a scale 1 to 10, how do you rate yourself, your business, convince the viewers? 1 being the best, 10 being the worst.
1 being the best and 10 being the worst.
Convince the viewers that Blame my Nelly.
With a
1. So 1.
I think I am doing the best I can do.
Oh,
and once you keep doing that, you keep putting yourself on them scales.
Oh, to convince the viewers, why is number 1?
Why am I number 1? Alright, okay. Well, for now, for one thing, when you come at me, you're getting exactly what you want. So you send a picture, anything, you're getting exactly what you want. So that is why I am number 1. Nobody knows what I mean. That's why you're doing exactly what you want.
Catch you, boy.
Yeah.
You've experienced working with a miserable client. Not satisfied. There's your rules. You could like come out more solo and keep your money.
To be honest with you, of course.
How do you deal with something like that?
I had one like that. I don't have her again because I had to tell her.
You tell her don't come back?
Why?
I think that as artists, people who discredit your work, it is again some hard blows. Now it has sometimes you will make mistakes. Nobody not perfect, right? But she was somebody. It wasn't only that she discredited my work. She was always late. She was late for appointments. And I am a person, I love being on time because I have appointments right after appointment. She was late for appointments. She was rude to my other clients. And she told me one day, look at these nails, you do it so ugly. And I'm like, girl, like,
if... Was her nails, huh?
No, but somebody else who, you know, but everybody have different styling. And
right.
I think I tried to tell her in a nice way, but some people don't hear exactly what, you know, coming off. And I'm like, you know, girl, but I find somebody who could really, you know, it's really more your style. At the end of the day, everybody, you want to be positive, you don't want no negativity around you, and I think that is an option for you. You could choose that.
Right.
You know, so money's not everything. That was my option at that time.
Okay.
Yeah?
Cool. You want to drink it, Lassen?
I've been drinking. No, this was a long ride, right? So we drink from the ride, come on the way down.
So it was some cocktails and so forth.
No, we have some. You know, we have. Yeah, I bought. You mean the cocktails that I brought? Yes. Where are they?
We done.
No, it's not done. Somewhere around, man. I see only drink. You all have a nice selection right here. I love it. Big up all there and stuff. But in my salon, I decided to add a menu, a bar, a nice cocktail bar. And I have some cocktails, me and my friend, you know, decided to do. And we have punch incrementing coming for the Christmas. So yeah, I started to do a nice little cocktail
bar. It's a saying that when a female gets her 10 nails done, she can't take care of herself.
That's not true. That's a myth. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
What do you
mean? 10 nails done is long. They can't
first, first of all, anybody who doing, who using the nails to wash that beautiful area, they're wrong. No, you're not supposed to use the nails to wash that hair.
Okay.
You understand? So, if you're doing that, something wrong. But no, that's not true. I think that was just a myth from men.
Okay.
They just don't like it. I don't know. They don't like the one that bake and the thing need now. So they don't like the plaques too much.
So they hear that there is a myth coming
that's
from
a whole myth. That's a myth.
By Nelly, what's your take on society labeling men who enter like cosmetics as being key?
No. I see some really good, actually. I followed like people like Young Nails and stuff, and their nail technicians are men, most of them. And they are not gay, they are married, they have kids and stuff, and they learn really well.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's not, I mean, I think that we, in the 21st century now, come on, let me stop with the labels and all that. Forget it.
So, big up there.
If a man wants to do nails and they want to learn, they can come by me and look.
You ever had it before?
No. But I would like to do.
So that male client come and say, babe, so how many nails done about it this way, that way, I'm going this part. You do it?
No, that's something wrong with that. But I would still do it. Uh-huh. You understand? I'm a professional.
Right.
But that's really up to you. Yeah, I will do that. Okay. That way you want. Yeah.
In terms of sale relevance, how do you go about marketing yourself, your business?
Definitely on Instagram. I have a nice little Instagram following. And I'll start my little TikTok. And you know, TikTok going now, so I market mainly on social media. Before, well, upgrade from walking around with flyers. I have my brand ambassadors. Now I have 3 brand ambassadors, and you know, they have a nice following as well, and they will put up my stuff. And you know, social media is a serious and nice market.
You wish to show them all, the brand ambassadors?
Of course. I have 2 with me right now. Alright, I have Shalisa. Big up Shalisa. Yeah,
big up Shalisa.
And big up Anthony Bravo. And big up Daniel. Thank you very much for
the work. What role does it play?
Anytime I have like a special or something, I just send it for our group, right? And I just send it for them, put up this, hashtag this, do this. And just do it. Just do one time. And if they do one time, I'll be like, do this, do it. One time. Yeah. No. If we have a nice little contract going,
okay.
You understand, they get their nails, do, now my ladies, they're doing the thing, they're independent. You understand, they're out there, they have shows, they do modeling and all those different things. So when they have model gigs and they have entertainment gigs, they will come do the nails, and I love that because I get my nails broadcasted even more. You know? Yeah.
Be the iron while you ever did the same style on 2 clients?
I did the same style on 5 clients. It has some people that just can't let it go. But you know what I'm not going to tell you, no? I'm going to say, girl, yes. That's what you want, you get what you want, you come here. Mm-hmm.
Like, I want butterflies, you butterflies. Same style, same color.
Same style, I just watch the page and I want this.
Okay.
Nothing different, I want this. And I have to do it. Mm-hmm. As much as I want, sometimes I don't even post it back because it's the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I might use it in a shorter length and I might say it on my story, but that's about it.
Any questions for
How do you balance being a mother and being the CEO of Bling by Nelly?
It's tough work, oh my gosh, it's a tough work. First of all, I get up really early. Now we have to teach our, so apart from being a nail tech and a mother, I'm also a teacher, because we have to teach our kids due to COVID. So the first half of the morning is dedicated to my beautiful son, and after that, we still don't want to be doing nails or whatever or any night. Yeah, so yeah, it does be tough. It does. While I'm doing schoolwork, sometimes I'm posting stuff, putting up appointment schedules, I'm setting up this, setting up, I'm in the schoolwork, plus I have to stop, do the schoolwork. Then I have to stop that because I have to cook, because I have a 5-year-old and see he's hungry at 11:30. So, yeah, I just do it. I get up no matter how tired I am, and I do it. Right. Yeah.
The floor is open.
Nobody. When you're on my location, Mount Pleasant Road, Arima, come and do your nails. Yeah, right?
What I want to say is that I love your energy.
Thank you.
You know, I start off the prayer and saying about all the energy. Uh-huh. And it's not a lie. You have good energy.
Thank you.
And as the CEO said, like you have all the questions.
Yeah.
Because before he asks, you could talk about it. So that alone is to tell you. So what I could tell you, God know your heart.
Yeah. I feel like at one point, I pray every morning, right? I pray, I get up no matter what time. I could be in the bathroom, I pray. I could be cooking, I pray, right? And at one point, I really prayed for an interview. And I was like, when these people come, I have them answers. Yeah, I had things to say, because I've been through it, and I had things to say, man. Just the other day I met a client of mine, and she was going through some stuff, same thing I went through, and it's been so nice that you actually could give advice now. I love that. Yeah.
the sky is the limit.
Yeah, that's so true.
You just go with.
Yeah. Walker Sands. What's your Lucas Sands, what?
Would you be having any giveaways coming up soon?
Of course! I love that. Right now I have a giveaway for Christmas, actually. Again, a Christmas set. You have to like my page. You have to like Team Visa page.
Right.
Nice. And tag three friends or like just join. And see if I can get a nice name. I will hook all up for Christmas, for sure.
Yeah.
That was the best question. I get it.
Because that's Rico, yeah.
First thing is God first. That's one thing, right? So when I get up, I pray in the morning. I do. I pray for good things, positivity all the way. So, I read a lot positive books, positive quotes, you know, all those seminars and stuff. I really wanted that, you know. So those are my principles. God first. You have your positivity, family, your business will flow. Fast. I believe in that. Yeah, I do.
Do you own a salon?
I had one, but now I have a studio, which I love.
It's located at?
It is in Mount Pleasant Road, Arima, right? Location will be dropped once you book your appointment. It's not far from the dial. It's literally like 5 or 10 minutes from the dial.
I passed the dial the other day.
It was fun.
I just passed the dial the other day.
How you feel?
Caturus?
No bites up there. Yeah. It's a nice vibe.
If given an opportunity to do something else, what would it be and why?
Oh my God, I know that was coming to this question and I could not find anything. I can't find anything. What True. Would I be? I love teaching. She's like an actor. Yeah. The mama is like, go and do acting, go and do it. She was pushing, she's like, go and do acting, you're good at that.
Acting?
Yes.
Are you acting right now?
I'm not acting. Okay. This is my vibe.
But let's say it's
But I love teaching though. I do. I love teaching. Not kids per se, but adults. So I might have been a professor or something like that.
A professor?
Yeah, like college professor. So
it's plenty worker.
No, but I would like be dying not say I'm doing that. I like working. When you realize that? I like to add stuff on my plate. And I like, when I sit down too long, I'd be like, oh gosh, I'm doing nothing in my place. I'll find something to fill in the gaps.
Mm.
Yeah.
Let me come to you, man. If given an opportunity to work with a celebrity, whether it be international or local, who would it be? And why?
To host.
Work with a celebrity.
Nicki Minaj.
For personality,
yes.
Why?
Because I know, oh gosh,
our brothers,
we like
team. You can stand the attitude?
Yes. I think I have. Similar attitude,
okay. We can't give you that because she's your boss.
No, I'm not going to give her the attitude, but I think we'll be on the point with the same thing. She'll be like, this is what happened. I'm like, how are you doing, girl? She'll be like, well, I react this way. I'm like, I would too. You know, and we would be best friends. I think so. I really believe that.
So like giving,
right? Yeah, we'll be like, yeah, calling each other and stuff like, girl, you see what happened? Yeah, we'll be like that. I love her. I love her energy. I'm like, I'm sorry. I just feel like she paved the way for a lot of our female rappers, so I have to make her up. I really do.
Okay.
Yeah.
This opportunity, team, I will give you to go to the camera to shout out some of your best clients.
My best.
Please don't forget nobody.
No, listen to me. Don't be feel bad, right? Somehow or less, I have a client from here and client from there on my phone. Sometimes I'll talk to somebody whole time doing the nails 4 or 5 times and I'll feel again. Yeah, boy, I feel bad. I just really, really feel bad.
So shut up, you remember.
But one of my most favorite clients is Celine, because she comes like clockwork and she brings different styles every time. And styles that's really creative and really cool. I love Celine. I love her. Yeah, she's real send people and stuff. So yeah. Celine for sure, let me think. Adana, definitely Adana. That's my girl, big up Adana as well. She as well. She comes, she misses no appointment. She's never late. That for nail text is so important to us. We just feel like we can give Ola so much hugs just by coming on time. Right. I'm telling you, it's really serious. So I love Anana too. I love Anana, I love Celine. I have so much people who's been passing through. Kimberly. Why? Because Kimberly does bring our vibe. When Kimberly come, we have to set aside the rest of the day for drink, because she's drink while we're doing it. We just take like an hour and something longer, but we just get it done and have fun. So I love that vibe. I really, really love it. Anybody?
No, best clients.
My and brand ambassadors.
Okay.
Oh, they are family, they are clients. That's a family now.
Okay.
These are family right now. This is part of the Bling by Nell family here.
Big up you.
They are so big up, all of them.
All of it is my bad, right?
Yeah, that's family, man. We just parents together.
Three words to describe Tanila Pula.
Three words, creative.
One.
Oh, good boy. Creative is one, definitely. I have to say independent. And hardworking. Independent / hardworking, because I'll do it. I'll go all the way for you all. Right? And funny. Based on our vibe, and we real build vibes in our studio. We just see things, it's be real nice. You feel like you find patience come with me. Yes. So at the end of the day, yeah, because sometimes I had like a client. No, I for the mothers that a baby in the hand and now that's hand no for the insects. But I'm telling you, some mothers really we don't have any way. So girl, hold our baby in the hand, I'll take my time. This hand first, next hand after. Baby sleeping, baby need anything, what you need, you hungry, and I'm so hungry. Yeah.
You get it. Yeah. Is it worse for
that?
She's got it done.
She's got
it done. Karima, come on. To what need? But this is brand ambassador. And Seth?
Yes.
Listen to the Team Visa TV. One of the brand ambassador, Miss Antoinette. Bravo. Listen.
Fine light, beautiful city. I just to be happy.
I cool for the hour.
You're cool.
What's up?
Well, I see you're sat with her only. You listen to our interview.
Mm-hmm. I feel like I think it was me.
Because you?
I tell you, I sort of feel overwhelmed since I'm down there.
True. What if it was for her? Like 95% was correct or incorrect?
She was on point.
Okay.
Yeah. I think you should tell, you should broadcast it.
How long you have known her, Mr. Me?
I've known her for some months, and it's years. Because she's a very friendly person, so she's not fake with it. Like I didn't really get the fakeness from her, so it comes natural. So as a client, once you meet her and you get her service done or your service done, automatically it's like family. You're
sticking
there. I don't think you're going anywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
I think I married you and I divorced paper gone. I don't even know where it is.
That's in terms of her work, right?
Yeah.
But
and her personality.
Okay. God, I say that as soon as an individual, as a person. What it is you discover with Lisa?
You like?
She's very real.
She real?
Yeah, like how she real.
Till the pinkest pink, black is black.
Like, when it comes to her work, I had a short story. So I was late. Twice. The first time I didn't know where I was going and I went quite a volunteer. And
that
then
was my experience.
And going through some skinny road.
So you know any children?
Yes. And the second time, after her, like, this is an overdue. So she was like, so, hi baby. Oh, hi babe.
where are you? I said, you know, it's all in real traffic. So why are you always late? And watch me. From the kicks and all the drama that we've been talking about, when it comes to her work, it's like, hey, pull up your socks, like you're late too often, and right. Come on, this is business. I want to fly up the road, yes? Mm-hmm. I say I would.
Let me jump relationship wise, mm-hmm. away from the job and everything, mm-hmm. because of her being a friend. Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah, I would say I consider her being a real good friend. Yeah, because
so keep this careful, yeah?
Alright, okay, next story. Next story. A little bit of my business, but in a nutshell. So the first time I met her, I was having going through a little something in my relationship that's no longer a relationship, it's just that. Okay, so
that
right there. So I was like, the same thing she mentioned earlier on in her interview with clients who come in to do their nails and, you know, they were just let out,
right.
You know, whatever it is they're going through now. And I was just like telling her, girl, so with him and what I saw, and she was like, she told me, no, you shouldn't even, you shouldn't even go through that. And I called her, like, on my way home, because I end up bouncing up.
How's your name?
I called her. Now, mind you, I do not know this individual. I don't know if it's just a front with her clients, and after that, the mask is off. I didn't know anything. But her energy is real and pure. I love her.
Where what's your most memorable moment with
Antonella?
Yeah.
We know each other so. Let me see. I think it was the first time we bring a son over. First time we bring a son over. And our son just clicked like that.
Okay.
Yeah, and then we started talking about being mothers and everything just clicked. So that was my most memorable. And when I really, when she, for some reason, people just open up on my table. I don't know why, but you're open up and I love it. And she just seemed like so independent. I feel like she's somebody going towards a really good path. And I'm like, I'm guiding this kid. We're going together.
Do you love her?
Of course.
Do you love her as a friend?
Of course I do. I feel like I know her for five years.
It's not friend, it's family.
I feel like I know her for 5 years.
This is the opportunity TV's I will give you to look into your family. Face
anyway,
and tell her something that she deserves to know or hear that she never heard before.
I would say that you have a very sweet personality, and that is what makes you stand out. That's what makes you stand out. Like, you want to make me cry very much.
I got
to
know more.
So that's what makes you stand out from the rest, from the other nail techs. And I'll say, keep being you and continue striving and just continue slaying those nails. I tell you, we outside. Thanks. You want it, Nikki? We outside.
Yeah.
What's up, look at dear friend, dear family?
My family, I love you. I too. I feel like I know you so long. Like, honestly, like we just click one time. Is that one phone call on the phone? I think like I know you so long, and I just want you to keep going, keep striving. You're very independent, and keep heading that way. Do what you have to do for your kid, and I know all it will be good.
All your team is actually there.
There's a full proposal on the screen. There's a full proposal.
With the flowers. It's like how TV's are looking into her business. Mm-hmm. I want to give you a flower because you've done an excellent job.
Thank you so much.
Don't wait till your friend, God forbid, let's say, right?
Yeah.
Watching you see the number of children in that box. Oh, and, I love you, don't tell her no. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Life is really too short, so.
I do.
I love you, I appreciate you. Because this one here, let me tell you, this girl, anytime I post about bad stylist girl done posted before, like she gets off my phone and play before me, you know. But you see thing, I know telling you, girl post this from a girl already done. Good. You know, I love it.
Okay.
Like once we have an agreement, is that we're going with, and even more.
Right. I still learning hot seat now, right?
Yeah,
going
yeah.
Individually. You first.
Uh-huh.
You're going on an island forever.
Uh-huh.
What are the three things you would carry?
My books.
Your books.
Definitely. My son, definitely.
Right.
My son, my books. I don't I can't by myself I don't go on this island. By myself I can carry my family over.
Three things?
My family have to go. My books.
Hmm.
Netflix account. That had to go, and I can't miss it.
We watching it on the box, huh?
But I had to watch that way.
No, we watching Netflix on the box.
No, it had no TV at all, at all. I could care more.
No, that's shooting, that's shooting, shooting, shooting.
I can't move forward because I don't watch it.
So
my
your phone,
my books,
and your books, and your son?
And my family, how to go. My intimate family, my kids. And my husband, I don't go, and I ain't good
right
now,
no
bigger feet.
And miss. Bravo.
No, this real tough, eh? Because I can say my makeup, my this, my that, my the other, but I'm through, right? So, I'll definitely say my little family. My music box. With my flash drive or whatever it is, because that will be another one, and there is three already. So I had a music box with the flash drive in it, that is another one. And my son, well, my son, mother, family, okay. Well, I had a bling by Nelly because my nails had a stay on that island. I'm not
sure. I came up on time on Netflix, so I still had to work.
Sure, meet me on the other side of the island. You have to slay.
That's not
your
problem. That's not your problem.
This is about bling.
Bye, Nelly. Big up, Shane. Anything you want to send on the side there? Any inspiration, any motivation speech? Anything you want to send on the side there?
Let's keep representing for the ladies in China.
Yes.
Keep pushing. And
keep pushing. Respect, man. Now we're coming to our close.
Mm-hmm.
You're getting interested, eh? No, before we go, write your handles. People can find you by Nelly.
You can find you following Bling by Nelly on Instagram. It is that Bling by Nelly. You can follow the Bling Effect. That is my personal page. You can follow All About Nelly. If you just want to see me and my wild self, you can follow that. Follow my TikTok all it. Well, seriously, I really want at 20. Right? Nelly.holder. Follow that for sure. I'm on Facebook as Bling the only, I believe. Yeah. I'm on Facebook as well. So yeah.
And once you're booking her, you can use my code AB and get 10% off any service she has to offer.
Wow!
You can use Shalisa and you can use
10% off.
Yeah, Danny as well and get 10% off.
Okay. Should come segment.
Hey!
Hello!
Yeah.
Should come segment. Somebody choose.
And guess what?
This is the time when it should come. You present your shoes to the camera and give you details about it.
Yeah,
no, take it off and let's present it to the camera.
Oh,
who goes first?
You go ahead, baby. I will take a while.
Pick up the shoe box and the shoes.
Oh my gosh, okay, so all I have one of the hottest style high boots you can find. So if you know Nelly and you come and sit down and you do nails by me, Nelly the shopping deals. So I get this beautiful suede black tie high sexy shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Three details. Love it.
We got you.
Yeah, we got you.
Before we close off, right? Worst advice ever given to you that you remember telling?
The worst
advice ever given to you?
That I will not amount to anything. Yeah.
It's not for me, no. The best advice ever given to you, though.
My grandmother, before she died, she said, anything you want to do in this life, you can do it once you put your mind to it. Yeah, everywhere I go. ago, even before I do the interview, I have my key and in my mind saying, if you really want to do something, you will do it. Put your mind to it.
I wouldn't ask Miss Antonia that because next week you have a kind of king. Show off now, then. Give me something. Show off.
Hey. But that's next week, Thursday. You can look out for me. I'll be here. Big up Team Visa TV. Big up Blink Binary. And big up me, Antonia Brown.
Yeah. Before you go, you're getting a little something that I can expect next week, please, you know, a cappella. Because your voice is great.
No, but you saying to give them something a cappella, that my voice is great, I will tell you to tell them to tune in next week, Thursday, and just exactly. See how great that is. No, yeah. I don't want to give all that. Tune in, big up Team Visa TV.
Yeah. And follow her. I would say follow her. Yeah. Follow her.
Antonelle underscore Bravo. Yes. Big up she.
No, Sharon Lai's voice. What? Sharon Lai's voice.
So we won't disclose that as yet, right? So you need to follow up. Just follow up.
Yeah, keep the excitement.
Yeah, let's build up our
events. Wow. We have come to our close. Any questions before we sign off? Anybody? Any words of advice you want to give to these young ladies? Maybe once, maybe twice.
This one I like to give advice.
I know. I love to hear. You know, I love to hear it coming from women. Love it. Yeah, I do.
You know, two young, powerful women, you know, it tells us a lot. You know, the sky is the limit, and don't limit yourself. You understand? And as Bling say, what her granny tell her. There are things my mom tell me too, you know? And it touch me. That's the word saying your granny give you that positive energy, you know? For two of y'all, what I could say, all you continue doing the good work, all you say, all his family, I seen it in all you. That is teamwork. That is positivity, you know? Don't let nobody come between that. Trust me, you know, it have people will find all the going good and for some reason they might want to split all you up. But my advice to all is, you're happening, all you know each other. If you don't like something that Bling say, or you don't like something as Bravo say, all you discuss it. Don't let it have a third party between you and all this family.
Right.
You know, and family means a lot to me. I love family. And this is what I see, you come with your family with you. And on behalf of Team Visa, we appreciate all them. We love all them. And we love all them.
Good talk,
yeah?
Yeah.
Ouch!
Yeah.
That's
she gonna
talk.
We have come to our close of this episode featuring Blink by Nelly. Alongside Anthony Bravo.
Yeah,
but we always close on a positive note, so this opportunity we'll give you to look into the camera. To close off with a positive.
Closing off, I would just like to tell all my females out there that they can do it. And I want to let them keep that positive energy going, honestly. I think we as young women, we have a lot of fight down, and sometimes we do fight each other down, and we could throw that aside. And start a positive movement to bring up our fellow sisters. Let's keep bringing up each other and we will be good. That is a good note.
A room for everybody. Really?
Look at the bigger picture, right? Life isn't always about, like she said, fighting down a brother or fighting down a sister. Just look at the bigger picture. I can do it, you can do it, we all can do it.
Yeah.
As a
who's your fellow?
My face?
Yeah. I.
Me, I did that.
Yeah.
So I have a page, I do makeup as well. Apart from singing and all kind of stuff. So you can follow Antonelle Bravo Magical Touch. You get your face beat in a nice way.
Yeah, I like that.
Wow.
Wow, good price. Well, we have come to our close. Thanks for being a part of TV, that TV interview series.
Thank you, it was nice. It was a pleasure. I enjoyed myself.
Hola, Bravo.
Yeah.
lot of useful episodes. Go subscribe to our YouTube channel at Team Visa TV. Follow us on Instagram at TeamVisa_TV for the latest update. We outside. Those are party one thing, please. You know,
join the today.